众朋友，大家好，欢迎来到今天的直击美股，我是主持人江柳，在华尔街向您问好。周二，美股标普大盘内医疗保健板块在开盘表现良好，一直保持着0.1%以上的涨幅，而在下午时分，涨幅有所收窄。在过去三个月内，医疗保健板块累计上涨超过6.5%，它的上涨却没能大幅度地提振标普大盘的表现，其余板块的下跌填平了医疗保健板块带来的上涨。美股开盘表现略显平淡，道琼斯工业平均指数上涨3.3点，涨幅小于0.1%，报21,412.36点。标普500和纳斯达克指数涨幅都小于0.1%，基本上属于平开状态。经过了数月的讨论和商议，共和党本周末有望发布党内关于修改奥巴马医疗法案的最后决议。如果共和党党内达成一致，该修改案将送达至众议院听取他们的意见，最终通过协商后在8月初递交至特朗普签署生效。而共和党党内对于新法案也存在着诸多争议，因此修改法案能否赶在9月份税收改革前落实也还是一个未知数。Everscore ISI 分析师 Terry Hans 在周二接受采访时表示，本周末共和党高层是否能就推翻奥巴马医疗法案做出实质性的进展，成败将在此一举。好的，更多股市消息，让我们来听 T3 首席执行官 Scott 的分析。
Good morning, my name is Scott, the Chief Strategic Officer at T3Live.com. Welcome to today's Morning Call Express. It is Tuesday.So pretty interesting, you know, overseas is not doing much, very mixed, so nothing to go on there. Our futures are down 2-3 handles after a nice little push from Friday into yesterday. Last week the pressure came off when the S&P cash held 2407 and then reclaimed the 50-day. And now we're trying to figure out, you know, what's next. Do we break out to new highs or are we stuck in this range and very stock specific? But that's usually what happens as we get closer to earnings season.Look at the chart here of the S&P cash, you'll see what I'm talking about. Last week, the bulls basically held the market where they had to. Where was that? You go across right here. That was a prior breakout area that turned into support. All of a sudden, we held, and then on a Friday, we took out the 50-day, closed back above it to take the pressure off, but we're still, you know, not in, you know, momentum mode.And at this point, I would say we probably don't get in momentum mode until we start seeing some of the bigger earnings come out. So for today, see if this 24-22-ish holds goes sideways. That would give us a little upper inside range to then maybe get going. But for today, not that compelling to the long or to the short side. You know, all the sectors still are somewhat mixed. The bios are playing with that 308 area. So we'll see what happens. The bios like to stop some people out before they go. At this particular point, it's still in the game. Big move from June, consolidating that, letting the 21-day catch up. Just if it does break below, you know, this 308, 49-ish area, and you get out, which is fine. If it comes back above it, make sure, you know, you lose a little, get back in, because they like to stop everyone out.Before it potentially goes. They did it right here with the red dog reversal at the 200-day. And then right here, before going, they had this one little down day that got a lot of people out, and then boom. So, you know, don't get too tight here. But a moving close below, yes, okay, then it can come back all the way down and you don't want to be in the way. But if it goes below and then comes back above, just know that's the pivot. You know, or you just wait for it to take out this area, but you'll be paying up, and that would confirm some momentum, because right now it's just in a consolidation phase.The banks are coming out with earnings later this week. They still look decent. In order for the market to hang in there, the XLF should continue to hold this upper flag. What do I mean by this upper flag? Well, here it is. You know, this was when the descending trend line was taken out. Great trade here. Then it was retested. And now it's holding above the 8-day moving average. In order for this to stay very constructive for the active bulls, some guys could be long versus the 8-day, which is right around 2460. And then if...bank earnings come in and it wants to go, your next tier buy would be above 2519 to continue. You know, you could look at all the banks themselves. I'm actually in Bank of America trying to, you know, anticipate that happening. But again, you know, when you anticipate, sometimes, you know, you get chopped up or, you know, you could be wrong. So at this point, though, I still like this pattern here a lot. Why do I like it? You know, it took out this 24 area. Now it's consolidating above the 8-day. So in my humble opinion, I think this...gets taken out to the upside, and there's, you know, decent middle before then. Watch JP Morgan and Goldman for that. Then in tech, today is Amazon Prime Day. You'll hear it everywhere. What you needed to do is on, on Friday when it took out 974, that was your spot to get long. Why would, you know, so today, you know, you might get some good news, but it's already up, you know, $4 into it. Why was this an important pivot point? Well, it basically took back a lot of moving averages and took out these three levels right here. So that was your long entry. You got paid yesterday, if that's the case. I was in it and I got out yesterday. I'm going to wait to get back in. Maybe holding sideways here for a little while creates a better pivot to break out from. And then lastly, you know, I know it's under a lot of scrutiny, but I do think that this Tesla could be a really good trade today. Yesterday, we talked about how to get involved for a Red Dog reversal. Well, if you did that yesterday, you made good money. What happened yesterday, they tried to push it below 306.30. It went to 303.13. When it went back above and the shorts got caught, it wound up creating a nice move here. So it did get me long, and I'm still long, and I'm thinking that it could be one more entry here. You know, so if it holds, just say 310, 312, and starts to go green, maybe you get one more push above this 318 to get near the gap, which takes it up to about 324. It could still be broken, because remember, this is when it lost the 8-day, this is when it lost the 21-day. That's when you probably should have exited, but that was a long time ago. And now if you did so into big support, you might be able to get a Q trade into the gap. If it breaks below 310-ish and it's really pressured, I'll just get out of the way and just, you know, take care. But if I see some relative strength and it looks like there's some buyers here, maybe this is a nice little trade into the gap for cash flow. So keep picking your spots, keep measuring the action, keep moving those feet, and keep making money. Have a good night.
好的，以上就是今天的全部内容。更多消息，请您继续关注我们的直击美股。我们明天再见。